Hello guys, my name is Disha and today in this video I'm gonna show you what do I do when I lose a nail. Here you can see I have lost my thumb nail. In fact, my pinky nail is also an extension that I've done, and you can see how nicely and beautifully is this done. It's just looking like your natural nail and it's quite durable, and it lasts to me up to 14 days it can last. It depends on the amount of work you're doing basically, and this is the secret behind it. What I use is a Conad Pro regular tips, and this is a pack of 100 tips. Sizes, all sizes are available here. Now like the box opens right here. For my thumb I'm using this size, for my pinky nail I use this size or this size, depending upon the size of your nail you can use. And this box comes of around, I don't know what did it costed me, it's 310 rupees it costed me. I bought it from slassy.com. I would be putting up the links in the description box right below, and I have two such boxes. Now I have taken out here three sizes of nails, you can see. Now how do you select the size of your nail is that you these are basically tips that we use for extension. Now in this you can see this is a little bigger than the size of my natural nail here on the sides. This one here is a little smaller. See, you can make out there is some space left. Now this one here is actually perfectly fitting to my nail. So first thing you have to do is to find out the size, perfect size of your nail. So I'll be removing these two tips. Now the other things that I'll be requiring is a buffer, basically buffer filer. This is a shiner as well, this side, but I'm gonna use this side here. Or you can use your simple metal file or an emery board file you can use. I will be using these two things for putting up. And my glue is this one, BYB Bond nail glue. This I bought from Bond Pretty store. It's a very nice glue. It has a brush inside, like just like your polish, it has a brush inside. So application is very simple. So now I'll be just starting up the procedure and showing you how do I do. Also I'm using this Bond 8 primer on my nail, and I have already applied it. What this does is it gives a balanced pH level to your nail so that everything sticks well. I even use it under my base coat. Primer is very nice to use. It always helps your base coat or whatever you are sticking on your nail to stick better and stay longer. So now I will be showing you how do I prepare my nail for this extension. Now first thing you can also do is that since it is very long, you can just clip half of its length. It is much easier. I know I do not have a proper clipper for this, but I am using my regular clipper. And obviously I'm gonna file it. I just shortened it, and I'll be just applying it here, right like that. So now I'll be preparing my nail. Actually I'm gonna buff it from this side. Here is my buffer, and I'm just gonna buff my nail so that my surface is a little rough. You should not have a shiny and a very nice plain surface. I'll be just filing it out. And once I have filed it out, I'll be taking my nail just like here and opening up my glue, and I would be applying the glue onto the nail just on 1/4 of the nail. I'll be applying the glue, closing the glue, because this glue is really sticky. So you have to be really careful with the glue. And I will be sticking on my nail on just the tip and would just press it down for some time. Press it hard, nice and firm so that it sticks on all the sides, especially on these sections where I'm pressing down. It's very important to press it down. Once it is stuck, it won't go anywhere. Press it down from this side as well. Take care your skin doesn't touches the glue. This skin does not touches the glue because glue is really sticky. Okay, so now after applying this extension, this glue is now completely dry and my nail is quite nicely stuck on. The first thing I have to do is to cut my length to the desired amount I want. So I will be cutting it down. I just hold my nail like that for some safety sake, and I'm gonna just cut out to the length I would love. Now this is a thumbnail, it is quite wide and I do not have a professional clipper, so it is a little difficult, but I would manage. And let me see, how do I do that? I very rarely lose nails, but when I do, I really do not like to actually cut down all my nails. So here is my shortened length, and I suppose this is the length I'm going to carry because I'm going to file it down still. Now I'm going to file it down to whatever length you need. You can file it down whatever shape you want. If you have oval nails, you can go for, I have sort of square oval nails, so I'm just gonna file them down. I'm keeping my filer very much straight so that I get a perfect square nail. And you can just check it out also in the middle. It's going a little, see, it's a little like that. So I'm gonna file this section down so that I get a perfect straight square nail. Now the main part of, I'm gonna go get it straight, as much straight as possible. You need to have a nice filer, nice buffer, a primer, and a very nice glue is most important. And the quality of your tips that you're using is also very, very important. And see, I am not a professional. I do it for myself, as everyone knows. It's my passion, and I have learned all these things working out on myself. Now see here, you can see my length. Now the most important part is to actually get the surface very much in level to your nail. Now for that, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use the same filer, and I'm gonna actually file it down like this. I'm gonna put it down and I'm gonna file it like this, so that from the sides as well, it should be a plain surface. It should not look like when you put the polish, it should not look like there are bumps on the surface. And I'm just gonna file it down like from all the sides. So I was telling you that I do this for myself, and whatever I have learned is I have done it on me and learned a lot of do's and don'ts in this thing. And I know how to do the plane, the surface plane and everything. Many a times I have made a mistake, but I know this is very, very safe, and your nail does not get affected. Your natural nail is very much safe in this. That is why I'm saying your glue should be very, very nice. Good quality glue is very important. So I have to get a natural shape. You can very nicely check it out, wipe out the dust. And you can check the surface by just running up your finger like so. If you can feel some bump, you can go on with the filing. And finish up with the filing, I'll be back. Okay, so here is my nail, and I have been filing it, and now it is filed down to such a point that now I cannot feel any bump. From every side, it's like perfectly sculpted. See, this comes by experience. And if you need to file it down, you can use a very thin emery board, this is. And I'll show you the package, so that if you want to buy it, you can just search for these. And I, from the side, I'm filing it out like this, so that it merges completely with your natural line, natural nail line. And from this side as well, I will be doing this. I won't be overdoing this. I would be just filing it out to a perfect square shape, nicely rounded corners. My nails are not with, they are of square length, but not with sharp corners. So now I'm completely satisfied with everything all around. So I can just wipe it out with my wet cotton round. And see, here is my extension. So that's my natural nail. And now I have a full length nail to match up my other nails. And I will also show you by applying the polish that I'm using. The polish that I have applied is this one by Sally Hansen. And before that, I will be also applying my primer, because I did apply my primer before to my base, but now to my length as well, I will be applying the primer nicely. And then after this, you should wear a base coat, but right now for you guys, I'm just gonna straight away applying the polish so that you can see the application nicely. See, it's a plain surface, so that's my one coat. And once this coat is completely dry, I can put in my second coat as well. So I hope this video helps you in case you lose a nail and now you won't be cutting out all your nails. If you can just get hold of these very nice lengths, if you get hold of these, please buy them. They are very much available on slassy.com or any other online site. You can buy these Conad Pro regular tips. These come in actually three colors. What I have are natural tips. They come in one clear and white as well. If you want, you can buy the clear one as well, but I prefer natural tips over both others. So see, here you can see my nail, and now it is completely in match with my other nails, and I actually love this. This nail is also an extension, and right now on my thumb also I'm carrying an extension. So this is a very nice thing to do in case you lose a nail. I hope I helped you in every manner, and I have tried my best to do this video. Now if you like this, please give a thumbs up and let me know what you have for me to say. Okay, so thank you. Thanks for watching. Bye.